Alright, in this video, I'm going to share with you how grandmother prepares yam agadi egg sauce. Exactly what you see on the screen. So in this video, we are making yam agadi egg sauce, grandmother style. Stay tuned, don't go away, let's cook together. So here is our fresh yam. I'll cut it round, just the same way grandmother cuts the yam. She's always cutting her yam in a round shape. So after cutting it into a round shapes, I will transfer it into a very clean bowl and then get a very clean sponge and begin to wash the skin of the yam. Please do wash yours properly, exactly what you see on the screen. Give it a very good wash until the yam's skin is properly washed, exactly what you see on the screen. Well, grandmother says cooking yam with the skin makes it more nutritious, and it is equally true for those who have eaten yam that is cooked with this skin. We tell you that it is very, very tasty, very, very delicious, especially with garden egg sauce. So please don't go away, let's cook together yam and garden egg sauce, grandmother style. So I'm giving this yam a second wash. Remember, we are going to cook it with the skin. We are not going to eat it with the skin, but we are cooking it with the skin to help maintain or retain the nutrients of the yam, and it is more healthy. Grandmother say it is more healthy, and it's actually very healthy cooking your yam with the skin. So this is it. After washing it, you see what it looks like. The skin is sparkling, everyone. So next, when the water I put on fire gets hot, I will add the yam that is already washed. All right, I will add the yam and then I'll cover it to cook for 10 good minutes on a medium heat. I'll cover to cook 10 minutes on a medium heat. Next, I will open the pot and add salt to taste. Cover to cook for another 10 minutes. So while that is on fire, here is our garden eggs. We have different types of garden eggs. Some are green, some are purple. So I have this yellow one. Next, I will transfer it into a very clean bowl. Then take my time to cut off the parts that are not needed, exactly what you see me doing on the screen. After that, I will wash it. Do the same, everyone. Hello everyone, if this is your first time here, you are highly welcome. If you're returning, you are highly welcome. Please don't forget to thumbs up, subscribe, comment and share. So next, after washing the garden egg, I will add it into the pot and cover to cook for 10 minutes on a medium flame. Do the same thing. So here is our fresh tomato. I'm just using very small scotch bonnet pepper and onions. Next, I'll blend this on a blender. Grandmother uses mortar, but I'm using a blender, and I'll grind it very rough. Don't blend it smooth, blend it very rough. And next, when the pan gets hot, I will add the quantity of palm oil I want to use, and when it gets hot, I will add my freshly chopped onions and stir it for 2 minutes. Stir it on a medium heat for 2 minutes. Doing this gives a nice flavor and a nice taste to your garden egg sauce, everyone. Next, I will add the paste, the tomato, scotch bonnet pepper and onions, and continue to stir on a medium flame for 10 good minutes. Make sure your pan is on a medium flame so that your sauce doesn't burn. Hello everyone, we are making yam and garden egg sauce, grandmother style. Don't go away. And then next, I will add dry catfish. You could use fresh fish if you want to, but grandmother uses dried fish and it gives it a very nice taste. It makes it very, very delicious. Very yummy, everyone. Those who have tried it must understand this. So next, I'll add seasoning to taste. Then I'll add salt to taste and continue to stir this on a medium flame for another 10 minutes. Give it a try, yam and garden egg sauce. Exactly the way grandmother prepares it, everyone. So I'll cover this on a low heat for 10 minutes. And then next, I will check if the yam is properly cooked. Yeah, everyone, the yam is properly cooked. And then the garden egg is also ready. You see, it is very soft. So next, I'm going to transfer this into a strainer, and then this is our sauce. It is almost ready after covering it for 10 minutes on a medium flame. So next, I will add the garden eggs. You don't need mortar to crush your garden eggs. It is properly cooked, so all you need to do is to use a very good turning stick and crush it. So when you do this, it allows the garden egg water to spill on your tomato paste, tomato sauce, giving it that delicious, nice flavor garden egg taste. Very, very yummy, everyone. And this is exactly how grandmother does it. She doesn't crush the garden eggs in a bowl before adding it into the stew. She crushed it inside the sauce to give it that juicy garden egg sauce taste, everyone. So I'm going to stir this for 5 minutes to combine. Stir to combine to give you that garden egg sauce taste, everyone. So our garden egg sauce is almost ready, but not yet ready. Don't go away, everyone. Let's watch to the end. And don't forget to thumbs up if this is your first time. And if you're returning, don't forget to thumbs up, everyone. Comment, like, subscribe, and also share this video to friends and family. So this is our garden egg sauce. It is ready. Grandmother garden egg sauce, yam and garden egg sauce, grandmother style is ready. Thanks everyone for watching. Thanks all my Jenny subscribers for all your support. I really appreciate. And if you're new, don't forget to thumbs up and subscribe if you've not done so. Stay safe, stay connected. See you in the next video. Bye for now.